Hi, this is Father Engel, your pastor, and welcome to St. Joseph. Here I am here beside this Advent wreath that we blessed last Sunday. And if you see here, the candle that we lighted to represent the first Sunday of Advent. And this week we are going to light the second candle to represent the second Sunday of Advent. And from there we go through these four Sundays of Advent before we celebrate the birthday of our Lord on the 25th of this month. So again, I'm very happy to reach out to everyone in their homes, especially, and to all of you who are receiving this video message. Well, as usual, I'd like to give you an update about what's going on with our church. And that we know, and you all know, that we are now back to the Paris Plaza again, or to the patio of the plaza, following the protocols and the directives coming from the county of Santa Clara, and of course of the Diocese of San Jose, with the spike of the COVID-19. So everyone is alerted again about this, and so we were ordered to close the church until further notice. And so, but we continue with our activities as usual. We still have our masses, daily masses at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, followed by a Eucharistic adoration at about 2:30 until 3:30 in the afternoon. And the same schedule of masses we have on Sundays. We have the usual 7, 8:30, 10 o'clock, 11:30, and then 1 o'clock in Spanish. But we also have two live stream masses as usual, one at 9 in the morning in English and at 11 o'clock in the morning for Spanish. Now, with the order to close our churches, well, the offices are also closed, and for that reason, the office of the Parish of St. Joseph is also closed. And it is closed until further notice. In our meeting this morning with a bishop, we pastors were told, I think starting on the 7th of this month, to again tell our staff that they should work from home. So, if you need anything from us, please don't hesitate to call us at this number, 650-967-3831. Leave a message on the phone, and Dayan or Perla, our parish staff, will return your call. I'd like also to tell you that our parish is still open for registrations for faith formation. Please call the parish number for registration. Bueno, queridos hermanos y hermanas, aquí estamos otra vez, y aquí estoy en la corona de Adviento, que, con la vela que hemos encendido la semana pasada, y la semana que viene, entra esta semana, vamos a encender esta vela para decirnos que estamos ya en el segundo domingo de Adviento, y lo vamos a encender todo cada semana hasta la Navidad. Bueno, que como ustedes saben, que por la directiva del condado de Santa Clara, igual con la directiva de la diócesis, hemos cerrado las iglesias otra vez aquí en el condado. Y entonces la parroquia de St. Joseph, en que pertenecemos, está cerrada, ¿no? Durante hasta que nos digan que abramos otra vez. Entonces, si ustedes necesitan algo de nosotros, por favor que nos llame a través del número 650-967-3831, y de allí deja un mensaje, un regalo, y Diana o Perla le va a llamar, okay? And also, our school continues to hold classes either through Zoom or through the physical presence of the students in the school. So there are two options actually in there. It all depends upon the parents, you know. And so with this message, I'd like to ask you, brothers and sisters, that we continue to support our school. And as I mentioned to our principal, Mrs. Jennifer Garcia, that I will be more proactive in the activities of the school, and perhaps even in its administration, given the fact that St. Joseph School is our parish school. And so it is incumbent upon me as pastor and all of us to be supportive of our school. And I'm very grateful to Mrs. Garcia, the school principal, for her leadership and coordination with me. This Sunday, which is usually the family mass, the first Sunday of the month, the family mass for the school and for all other families of our parish, I'd like to reach out to all of our parents, the parents of our children, the school, including all the parents of the parish, you know, that indeed we remember families, especially on the first Sunday of the month, for that purpose. Also, regarding the school, I'd like to reach out to all our alumni, you know, to the graduates of our school, and that I'd like to ask you for your continued support for our school. I've mentioned to Mrs. Garcia this week that I'd like to partner with other parishes, the neighboring parishes of St. Athanasius and St. Cyprian, for the possibility of for me and for the school to promote our school in their parishes, to get students from their parishes to enroll in our school. So I'll contact the pastors of these parishes for this purpose. Queridos hermanos, que como ya he dicho, ¿no? Que con todas las actividades que tenemos aquí, nadie ni nada nos puede parar, ¿me entiendes? Que seguimos con lo mismo, seguimos con las actividades más, las misas, ¿no? Misas diarias, la hora santa que hacemos cada día, lunes hasta sábado, después de la misa. Todo esto continuamos haciéndolos, ¿verdad? Y también me gustaría decir a ustedes que yo tengo una gran ilusión de meterme más en las actividades también de la escuela de nosotros. No se olviden que nuestra parroquia tiene una escuela, se llama St. Joseph School. Y estoy mirando a qué manera la parroquia puede ayudar o apoyar la escuela. De todas formas, como ya estamos haciendo, que cada primer domingo del mes la segunda colecta va a la escuela y también la misa se ofrece para todos los miembros de la escuela, los padres, los niños que están allí, las maestras y la directora también de la escuela y para todos nosotros. A ver, sí, que con esta, ¿no? con este apoyo, ¿no? Por lo menos los propósitos que estamos haciendo, podemos ayudar la escuela. Please, brothers and sisters in Christ, I ask you to continue to stay safe during this time, you know. As the county told us that there's a spike of COVID-19, so stay safe. I understand the frustration that many of you have due to the sudden change after 1 month of coming back to the church for the services. I remember that when we were told a month ago that we can come to the church again, we were also excited, we were very happy, and suddenly the change came. I could understand how frustrated you are, just as I'm really frustrated too. But what can we do? You know, our health is a priority. You know, we have to be careful about this virus, and that we try all our best to protect ourselves and protect others. And for that reason, the church comes to our aid to help us. You know, the season of Advent is a way for us to stop for a moment and think things that are more important in life, you know, and especially our relationship with Jesus. The Advent season tells us that we must prepare. In the Gospel this week, we will hear from the Gospel of Mark the words of the prophet Isaiah, where it says, "Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight his path." So I think that would be a nice thing for us to reflect on. Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight his path. Meaning to say, allow him to mold us. Allow him to follow us. Allow him to inspire us to change so that we can prepare ourselves for the coming of the Lord. Bueno, queridos hermanos y hermanas, como siempre, en medio de las frustraciones, desilusiones que tenemos a causa de esta pandemia, estamos aquí todos, ¿no? Haciendo todo lo que podemos hacer, ¿no? Con la gracia de Dios, de seguir adelante. Bueno, la Iglesia nos ayuda en este momento de ponernos en una reflexión de qué significa todas estas cosas que está pasando con nosotros. Y en ese tiempo de Adviento, aquí estamos, ¿no? Con el Adviento para recordarnos lo más importante en nuestra vida. En esta semana vamos a escuchar la palabra de Dios, por ejemplo, en el Evangelio de San Marcos que vamos a leer en esta semana. Allí salen las palabras del profeta Isaías diciendo que preparen al camino del Señor, así dice. No endurezcan sus corazones, así dice las palabras. Y quizá ese es un gran mensaje para todos nosotros, ¿no? Dios nos está hablando, nos está pidiendo que nos cambiemos en nuestros corazones, ¿no? Para seguir adelante, para seguir a Cristo en ese camino de santidad. Y entonces, póngalo, ¿no? En este camino, ¿no? Pongan este camino, queridos hermanos, porque Dios está con nosotros. And again, to all of you, I'd like to assure you of my prayers, and may God bless you and your family. Bueno, bendiciones a todos, y les aseguro mis oraciones.